really got to me actually, and the fact is that I love the special effect. But then before we go into that, actually, we all agree that we've made it known to us that this is an Imoh Umoren project. But then to a lot of people at home, we don't know who Imoh Umoren is. So can you guys just quickly tell us who Imoh is, and then we go into the nitty-gritty of other matters?
Okay.
Would you like to? Imoh is an award-winning film director, and he has been working, he's worked in TV for a while, he's worked in film, and he's done a bunch of short films, and he's pretty renowned out there, and he's known for diving out of the mainstream and doing human stories, so to speak, and he's a fantastic director in my opinion.
I love the fact that from the trailer you can see that the story is quite true to life. It's not the fake reality that they try to create. It's true to life. So what was your experience while shooting this movie?
It was humanizing for me. The character I played, I played alongside Tope Tedola's character, where he comes for a job interview and I turn him down. The character is me.
It's
not the character wearing glasses. I don't wear glasses.
You're mean. Seun Kentebe, you were mean to that guy.
I thought he was my friend. But you know, that's what operates in business, really. It's not about sentiments. You have to have the right qualifications and specifications for the job.
The character was it with the right qualification?
He had the right qualifications.
But not the right specifications.
That's really sad. And it's true to life. Yeah. That's what happens.
Okay, I'd like to ask you, for me, first of all, the makeup is really, the special effect is really dope. Mm. We're seeing that kind of special effect in movies where we don't have to, how will I put it now? It's not fake. It's real. It's almost true to life.
Almost organic.
Now, how long, for each day of the shoot, how long does it take you to get Tokwe into that character mode with all of that makeup? How long does it take?
I would say like close to 3 hours.
Yeah. 3 hours? What? It sits on a chair for 3 hours?
First of all, it's pre-modeled. You just put it on his face. Okay. So it takes, give or take 2 hours. Now kind of have to blend it. It doesn't look fake. So that's what takes the most of your time.
So what was the most challenging part? Because that sounds really challenging. Yeah. What was the most challenging part of shooting a movie for both of you, individual experiences? You can carry it. Why are you guys being gentlemen to each other? I'm the lady here.
First of all, I think it was the technicality of the film. First, me and Imoh decided on the style, and it's pretty new down here, and it was sort of experimental for both of us.
Really, what kind of style? You can let us know what style is that?
The visual style of the film. If you notice, it was simple. It was most of the shots were static. We weren't moving too much. We didn't do too much of production design. We weren't building sets. We found locations that we needed, and we just shot most of what we needed in those locations.
Basically, you, while you had what you wanted to do in your mind, when you got to some of those locations, you shot based on
what we already had.
You didn't build a set for the film. You made the film fit the set.
Exactly.
So
we were trying to create sort of like a heightened sense of realism. So we weren't doing anything fake. So we were challenged by, sometimes we go to a location and it wasn't really what we expected, but we have to find a way to, blend the elements and just, tag along with the story. It was really an interesting experience.
Okay, I'll call you.
Okay.
For me, well, with my character, having to face the disfigured person and having to turn him down.
You know the person behind the mask.
At that point in time, I don't. We're worlds apart. I'm just trying to, as much as I try to sympathize with him, I also have to be business minded about it and say, look, I'm not going to give you the job based on your present situation. You can't deliver, basically, and I'm sorry, I just have to let you go.
Okay, before we go on, I'd like to tell you that the phone lines are open and the numbers to call, Gyro.
08091222283, 08091222284, 08091222285, and 08091222286. Also 0814000283 and 284.
Pick up that phone and
call now.
Right now.
Now.
Okay, what does people talk about? especially in the acting world, you hear people say, I'm a method actor. People say, I am this, I am that. And then method acting, to a large extent, has been one of the most gruesome form of acting for me, because it takes, it's very demanding. Sure. It takes you being that character. Now, for this kind of story, did you method act, or did anyone on set method act? You had first-hand information on that one.
I think there was quite a lot of method acting. Talk about Tetela's character, for one, having to shoehorn himself into that situation, you know, carrying that burden of a man who basically has lost it all, but is still trying to make something of himself, and then going through each door and having it slammed in his face, you know, carrying the whole burden of each experience into each scene, and still having this sense of survival, this sense of redemption.
I'm not going to give up,
you know, optimism. And for my character, having, you know, I've come across a lot of people like him who have one problem or the other, and expecting that, well, he wasn't expecting to get a free ride, but based on merit, in a sense, you would think, okay, look beyond the other thing and just hire me because I'm good at what I do. But then I also come from a background of, it's not just about what you have on paper, the look. For instance, now the banking sector, the banking sector or whatever sector it is, there are specifics that they look out for, you know, when they want to hire employees. And if you don't fit the brief, forget what you have on paper.
Before you go on, we've got Freeborn from River State on the phone line. Freeborn, good morning. How are you doing?
Morning, Freeborn.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Can you speak up a bit, please, Freeborn?
My name is Freeborn.
Yeah,
okay,
Freeborn.
Okay, perfect. How are you?
Okay, fine. Go ahead. There's Tokwe and there's Geezy.
Yes. I just watched the trailer of the movie.
Okay.
I don't know the title of the movie, and I don't even understand the movie.
Okay.
It's called Happyness Limited.
Did you hear that?
Happiness Limited.
Limited.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right. Did you see the trailer?
I saw the trailer, but I don't really understand it. You know, you can ask them.
They will explain to you.
Be able to understand the movie.
Okay.
It's not really understand, but able to cheer you up so that you down. You look for the movie and watch, but the trailer does not really move me to say that.
Okay, the trailer. Okay. Well, first of all, before I say anything, I'll leave it to talk about to Seun and why am I calling you Tokwe? What did you use? Seun and Geezy to actually
look like
but without
him
giving anything away.
Without giving anything away. Well, the basis of the movie, like we earlier said, is about a young man who loses everything in the fire, and he's trying to pick up the pieces of his life. And of course, you saw the character played by Tokwe Tedela, who is disfigured facially, and he's trying to come back. He's trying to stage a comeback, and so he goes through various oppositions, but is still determined to, you know, succeed.
Wow.
Which is something I'm sure every Nigerian and everyone can relate to.
Can relate it to Leicester City.
Underdogs that finally came on top.
Big dogs.
The character of the guy that was born was okay, but it was that I didn't really get it. From the trailer, that's why I called it.
Okay, one thing trailers are, there's, I like, the trailer has done what is expected to do, actually.
Exactly, it makes you want to know more about it.
Exactly. So watch out for the movie when it's out, so you go see
right,
it in the cinema.
We're not trying to give too much away, all right?
Thank you very much.
It caught your attention, and we're glad it did.
Right.
Thank you, Freeborn.
Thank you. Bye.
Okay, Seun. I won't call you Tokwe again.
You just had to make it very, very quick.
Okay, I like this one to Geezy. I've always known DOPs to not to get, when I say involved, they don't get emotionally involved in the project most of the time.
Yeah,
they want to throw in banters from behind the cameras with the technical crew. They tend to just lighten the mood. But then this looks like a very, very serious movie.
Yeah.
How were you able to make the ambience work for the movie in general without losing face or character?
Like I said, I and the director decided on the style. We were very specific and we followed it to the letter.
Okay.
So if you notice, it's not conventional cinematography that we have applied here. We were kind of just on it. We would go and we'd shoot, we'd find what we needed. We knew each shot we needed to take at every point in time. So, and we used a single camera setup.
Wow.
So, I mean, every single time we were on set, we knew exactly what we were going to shoot and we knew what part of the film that shot would be on screen. So we went bang on and we shot it.
Okay, but for a normal movie viewer, you would not know the technicality that went into making a movie. So what is it about this movie that would make me go to the cinema? What's the selling point?
Well, I would say the selling point is the story.
The story.
The story.
It's all about the story.
It's all about the story.
All right.
Definitely. Okay. You're an actor. And I've heard actors say they don't like D.O.P.s sometimes. Yes or no?
Yeah, they don't. What you're trying to do. You're putting them against each other.
I'm not pitching you. I'm not pitching anyone against each other. Okay. So, you know. Yeah. It's just like stage actors don't always like stage managers.
Stage managers. Mm.
You understand? Nah. So, we all know the way it works, you know. The D.O.P.s sometimes tend to control you after your director is done.
Don't look at him.
Okay, you should look at him. Okay.
Look at me.
Now.
Okay.
That's a distraction.
No, he's looking at me, you're not looking at me, don't worry.
Sheo, for you, first of all, before we go into the director, your working relationship with the director, how was it like working with this guy who seems too cool?
Truthful.
Too cool. To be too cool.
How terrible was he?
Funny enough, he wasn't. He was, how do I put it? He was there. You know, and at the same time, he wasn't. He was like an invisible man, so to speak.
Yeah, no.
That being said, Like earlier said, he and the director had already collaborated. They already knew what they wanted.
Okay.
So, and we had already discussed before shoot. And so, you know, after each shot was taken, it was just, okay, you need to do it this way and do it that way, sit in a particular position. But it wasn't anything that was, that would get on my nerves.
Okay.
You know, I think he's not that kind of guy. He's a cool guy. Cool.
I don't like what this guy sounds like.
Both of them have conspired to
This is a reality.
These two have conspired to say yes, you have done well. But Imoh, I know you are a very plain and truthful person. So please you come on this show and tell us how it is like working with these
two guys. Realism.
Well, with me, this is my third rodeo with Imoh.
Okay.
You know, and what
were the first two projects?
The first two projects, the first one was a web series called what was it called again?
I can't remember the name.
Second one was a short film called Liftoff. And then this Happiness Limited.
Okay.
I think the issue is understanding your the director's approach.
Okay.
You know, how he wants things done. And once there's that understanding between the actor, the director, and the DOP, and of course.
How does Imoh want things done? I really like you to break that one down.
Imoh is thorough. He's thorough, and he's someone who gives actors leeway. You don't necessarily have to stick to the script,
but at the same time,
you don't go overboard.
Okay, all right.
You know, so it's still how do I put it? Being on a comfortable level.
More like you're saying, he gives you the foundation, and then allows you to express yourself in your own creativity.
As long as you say within the scope of the.
You're not an actor, so how was it working with him? Is this your first project with him?
I don't know. It's my first scripted project with him, but we had worked on a bunch of other projects.
So what was he like? What was he like playing?
It was awesome. And
okay, carry on.
Okay, the BAFTA was awesome. The BAFTA was this weekend. And very interesting. If you have a chance to have a work submitted for the BAFTA, I'm coming to you.
No,
just cool down. You're an actor. Every actor has got their eyes on the words. Not because their word is the main thing, but it is the main thing actually.
Yes,
but
it also is.
Actually points the point out the fact that you're doing something really good.
True.
So if you have the chance to put this film right there in the face of the people, and then from AMA to AMVCA, straight up to the BAFTA, if you can get a chance, straight up to some of the film festivals, what do you think will be the high point of this movie? Selling point, high point.
Like you rightly said, the story.
The story.
So the story. Production value. Story is number one. Okay. I think it was Imoh. Brainchild. And he's been on it for 2 years.
Yeah.
That's a long time.
It's been a minute.
So why did he delay? Why did it take so long before the project came to being? What was he waiting for?
I believe he was working on another commercial project. Because you know.
So it's high time the movie came out. Mm-hmm. It's the right time.
Jaro, let me challenge you. to challenge him.
Okay, carry on.
He's too laid back for my liking.
Yeah, he's a cool guy.
No, when I see a movie like this, I'm always skeptical.
Why is that?
Maybe the camera angle is gone wrong.
I think the thing is, there's been a paradigm shift.
Okay.
So, back then, when Nollywood, you know, came about, you had DOPs who felt like demigods.
They were terrorists.
Yeah. You know, they're terrorists, demigods, whatever you choose to call them. Mm. And the working relationship between the DOPs and the actors were not cordial.
It's a new era.
You know, right, but right now it's a new era. And you know,
so this has taken you all the way. It's worked for all your projects. You're cool with people, and they don't give you any problems.
As long as I have an understanding of the
director. Is it part of the new era because he's wearing 90s baby?
Don't be deceived by that trucker. I don't trust this dude.
He said nothing. When I was like, you're a 90s baby, are you making me feel old? And he's like, oh.
Of course you must claim. I'm a 90s baby too.
What?
Okay, wait. Let's start. I'm sure you know Frank Sinatra. Of course, now we're getting there. I'm sure you know Prince.
Prince, oh yes.
You know Prince. I love Prince. Sing one of Prince's song.
I don't know Prince's song.
Sing one of Prince's song.
Ta-ta-ta-ta. You sexy mother. Do-do-do-do. Do-do-do-do.
What about?
Do-do-do-do.
That's the ultimate litmus test.
Okay. Michael Jackson is the litmus test, don't you?
And everybody knows Michael Jackson.
Everyone knows Michael Jackson.
Well, that's true. Michael Jackson.
That's true. Okay, who can we call for now, if not Michael Jackson?
Actors.
Actors.
Yes.
What year?
This year.
No, yeah, this year.
People really pay attention to that.
Okay,
this year.
Actors.
This year.
Foreign or Nigerian?
Both. Home base and foreign base.
Okay, home base, foreign base. This way, Tommy, Tokpa Tedela, Seun Kentebe.
You worked with Tokpa Tedela, so why would you know him?
You're a cheat, man. Okay, now he's a director of production, so both actors.
Actors.
I really like Kiki. I feel like no one's talking about her.
She's pretty.
No, besides that, she's a phenomenal actress.
She's an amazing actress, and she did really well on the Happiness Limited.
Oh, nice. Outside the
Happiness Limited.
I like DSF, Dola, and Dokas. What's her name? Mrs. DSF, Dokas, okay. Falash, Fabson.
Dokas, so if you were to give any recent movie an award, which one would it be and for what?
Home base.
Yes. Recent.
That would be World Bangers, Bomb Bomb Express.
Why would you give the name?
Say it again.
Bomb Bomb Express.
What would you give it an award for?
The cinematography, the style.
Wonderful. Great. So when you look at a movie, you always watch out for that?
By default.
Okay, foreign.
Foreign movie this year,
Jungle Book.
Let him land.
I'm looking at him like,
okay. I already have that movie in mind.
What movie is that?
Batman vs. Superman.
What did you like about it?
It was comic book come to life.
A lot of people complained about that particular movie.
I grew up on comics.
Oh, so.
Okay.
He's an Ojo Legba boy, and then he takes his money to international magazine.
What are you talking about? I grew up in Lere, man.
Lere.
It's the same thing. Lere.
What part of Lere?
There's a difference. There's a connect.
Really?
What part
of? Clegg Street.
Clegg Street. The funniest thing about Clegg is
PH boy.
I'm a Port Harcourt boy.
You're Larry, now you're Port Harcourt.
No, I'm
everywhere. I don't know. Nice.
He said he grew up at Clegg Street. Mm-hmm. Clegg, you just come out of Clegg Street straight. It's on Yoruba Bridge that's in front of you.
Which is why there's a disconnect. It's before.
We're still within the Sulere confine.
Oh, Shem, I'm not surprised you chose Batman Superman because there was a time your DP was actually Superman.
Oh.
Superman's logo.
But
then really, if you have a chance to play, to work with any foreign director, who would it be?
That's a tough one because there are a lot. Okay. I'd love to work with Nicholas Winding Refn.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Why?
His narratives, his visual styles are different.
Okay.
And he does more of the unconventional.
Okay.
You know, he's not a mainstream person, but I think Drive was able to cross over. I'm someone who would like to play, you know, those kind of characters, kind of dark characters, you know.
Okay.
Nice.
Ryan Gosling did a wonderful job
okay.
you know, with his character. And, you know, Nicholas, he's just He's an okay guy.
That's one person.
That's one person. Okay. Of course, Spielberg is by default.
Yeah. By default.
Everybody wants to work with Spielberg.
No, that's Quentin.
Oh, Quentin Tarantino. Robert Rodriguez.
There's this guy I love so much. It's not very particularly in mainstream. Baz Luhrmann.
No Country for Old Men.
Romeo and Juliet, Moulin Rouge. And all that. I just love Baz too, but then that's you. You're talking about you. You, sir.
Nolan.
Okay, now I want to throw you guys under the bus. Can I?
Yeah, go ahead.
Okay. If you want to make a movie right now, choose a movie title. Choose a very quick storyline. Let's analyze the film.
Geezy.
That's a tough one.
There must be that storyline in your head that you're like, no, I'm going to do this. I'm going to do this very soon. Nothing like that.
No, that I
you always want to be a D.O.P. for people. Your own movie.
I'd like to do a story, a one character story.
One character? Wow. Yeah. What do you think about one character story?
Well, if it's engaging, there has been a couple.
Don't talk. Let me finish. I didn't want you to mention Locke.
She didn't even like him to anything else. So
yeah. One character. Why one character? Why?
Because I feel like people don't appreciate the. I don't know. People don't really appreciate monologues in movies. And
but that's more of theatre. If you look at it,
one character, it's to get boring.
No, except it's a short film.
No, it doesn't. One character, multiple locations.
It gives you the chance to actually explore. Right?
Okay.
Yeah, but they're not chill. There's something I'm waiting for here. Maybe why if you. One character movie. What would you like to be to star in one character film?
I'd like to star in one character movie. Definitely.
The guy has got to have multiple personalities.
Absolutely. Well, even if it's not multiple personalities.
You mentioned Locke now. Mm-hmm. Even Locke.
And you can imagine everything was done
in a car.
Okay.
For like an hour plus.
Okay.
And it was engaging from beginning to the end.
Wow. So are you choosing the one character movie too for your own personal?
No, I like interaction.
Interaction.
I like interaction. So
how many casts? 1,000, 5,000?
Not at all. Say like five?
Five.
Basically. I'd call it Police and Thief.
That's interesting. Now that will get my attention.
This is somebody from the 80s.
He played games.
You remember the game?
What was it like?
Police and Thief. Uh-huh. It wasn't nice. My cousin was the thief who always got away.
Okay, what happened? This childhood game?
He didn't play.
He was a geek.
Somebody
will grow up.
Call of Duty.
I've heard that one before.
Call of Duty is a video game.
You didn't run around the street.
Kind of that actually would pick the barrel of the cover of their a particular brand of pen, and you put matches in it and turn it into a gun.
Whoa.
Or you pick your exercise book, roll up your paper, and then that's a gun. And then to make it stronger, so that it'll be straighter, so that it won't bend. Depending on how long you made the nozzle, now put igbale, broomstick.
Yeah. Okay.
Wow.
I don't know about that one. I know about cooking with sand.
We didn't cook with sand.
Seriously, boys cooked with sand.
I cooked with sand with my sister.
Exactly. Now, this is a real man. He's emotional. He's connected.
Okay, now, let's get back to you. Okay.
All right.
Okay, all right. Now, let's talk. Is Happiness Limited now? Let's get back to that one now.
Right.
Really now? Okay, we got two of you here. Well, we've seen Tokwete Dela, we've seen the little girl, we've seen your other actors, we've seen Kiki O'Malley, and it seems to be crushing over Kiki. But what's it like with all the other actors in the movie? What was it like?
Well, my scene was just with Tokwete, was a cameo.
Okay.
But I have faith in the cast. It was an amazing, cast. Kiki, Gregory, Kingsley, Tokpe, the little girl, Miriam.
Yeah, Miriam.
Thinking about, wonderful acting, wonderful delivery. They sold the story.
Okay, so your prediction for the movie in the market?
I think it'll be hugely successful.
Mm. Cinema?
Not because I was on it, but because I really think that the story is really, it's an engaging story.
Okay. I believe so too, because like I said earlier on, the story is something that would resonate with a lot of people, especially
the current times in the country,
especially
right
with the current situation in our country.
I think stories generally, fine, of course the period matters, but I think that naturally when you have a good story that the people can relate to, people would always relate to it because they're humans. Mm. But then I'd like to ask you now, Geezy.
Right.
I know that after a while, DOPs tend to always want to jump and transcend and sit on the chair. Okay. Any plans for you becoming a future director?
One man movie.
Absolutely.
Why would you want to become a director?
Because I want to tell my stories.
Oh,
wanna
nice.
I
like
to tell my stories.
It's pretty plain and simple.
Mm. Seun Kentebe. Mm-hmm. I know you want to be jack of all trades and master of all?
All sets.
Most of
okay, it. Okay,
sprinkles.
Really, now, any plans of you know, transiting and becoming a director somewhere in the future?
Director, sometime in the future, maybe. Right now, I'm focusing more on writing and producing.
Okay. Oh, nice.
You know, there's a company I floated called Eskens Productions. Mm. Although I'm looking to start with theatre. Theatre has basically been home for me. Mm. So it's my own way of giving back. Although I have also written a few scripts for film.
Okay.
You know, but I'm looking to kick off with theatre first.
Somewhere down the line. You both talked about delving into filmmaking and production and all that. I just remember the MopiCon bill. Nobody's saying nothing about
well,
that.
Well, let's leave
the MopiCon out of this.
This is not about MopiCon. There'll be a time when we come and talk about MopiCon.
Mm.
Quickly now, finally.
Last but not least.
If you have one thing that you'd like to change on in that story in Happyness Limited, what will it be?
He said he doesn't want to change it.
No, it's not my vision.
Okay. How do I respond to that without giving away the story?
Mm.
We should go see it in
the So when is the movie coming out? How do we get information about it?
It's coming out in August and we'll definitely keep you posted.
Okay. Okay.
And so we'll bring you more here.
I promise. Agreed.
I'll be here.
Okay. All right, then. How do we follow you on social media?
Social media, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, Seun Kentebe.
Seun Kentebe.
I thought you was going to miss it. Geezy.
Prodigeezy. Everywhere, anyway.
Spell it.
Prodigeezy. Instagram, Twitter, everywhere else.
Nice.
Okay. Well, it's been an amazing morning. Of course, we could go on and on and talk about this and talk with these two gentlemen here. Mm. They've been very amazing.
And my boo. Mm. I see a ring, but I know it.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the part where you will not listen to Gyro. This is the part where we would like to say keep it locked down, because R2TV will surely continue after the breakfast show. But then, of course, keep it locked down as well. Mm. You can see a repeat of this show later in the day.
2:30.
And don't also forget that tomorrow morning, Tuesday, we'll be here live and direct coming from the R2TV studios. My name is Adeoye Saleh.
And my